Hey, math class, I just want to give you a few more examples of subtracting fractions. So, again, this is very like the other example from the other video. Once you have the common denominator, it's like addition in that way. You have to have a common denominator. But once you have that, then it's just simply subtracting the two top numbers. So, 9, I have two 9s on the bottom, and so that means I have a common denominator. I can go ahead and subtract the 2 from the 5. So 5 minus 2 is 3. My bottom number is going to stay the same, okay? And now, as with every answer that we get when we're working with fractions, we have to ask our two questions. So, number one, is it a proper fraction? I have my smaller number on top than on the bottom, so yes, it is a proper fraction. Second question, is it reduced down? Is it simplified? Is it in its lowest terms? And in this case, I can look at it and say, no, gosh, you know, these two numbers, the 3 and the 9, have a factor in common, so I can divide that greatest common factor out. And again, just to review, let's list out the factors of 3. Well, 1 and 3, right? Because it's prime. So 3 is its prime because its only factors are 1 in itself, and we'll list out the factors for 9 here also, okay? 1 times 9 is 9, and 3 times 3 is 9. So here are our factors. And look, there's 3 on both of them. So what I'm going to do is come back over here, divide a 3 out of both of these. 3 divided by 3 is 1, 9 divided by 3 is 3. And there is my answer. So 5/9 minus 2/9 is actually 1/3. Okay, you say, that's all great, but what happens if I have a mixed number or two mixed numbers and I'm subtracting them? And the process is very similar to addition. You're just going to make sure you're going to deal with everything in its own little column, right? So you're going to deal with the fractions on their own, deal with the whole numbers separately, okay? So I'm going to start with my fractions. I've got a common denominator, right? I've got 7 on the bottom of both of those. So that means all I do is subtract my top numbers. 6 minus 2 is 4. My bottom number stays the same. And then I come over here and I subtract my whole numbers. 8 minus 5 is 3. I'm going to ask myself my two questions. Number one, is this a proper fraction? And the answer is yes, it is, because 4 is a smaller number and it's on top, so we're all good. Question two, is it reduced down as far as it can go? And just to double check over here, what are the factors of 4? Well, I have 1 and 4, and then I have 2, because 2 times 2 is 4, right? What are the factors of 7? Well, 7 is prime, right? The only factors it has are 1 in itself. I have no factors in common. No factors in common. So I know that this is reduced down as far as it can go. And so 3/4 is my, or I lied, 3 4/7 is my answer. Okay, what happens if they have different denominators? So this is something that the first video didn't talk about. He gave us an example that had the same denominator. What happens if they're different? So again, it's like adding. We just have to convert it, find the least common multiple between these two numbers on the bottom. So in this example, 2 and 10. And we'll make that our common denominator and then convert the top, right? And then we'll subtract. All right, let's do all of that. What are the multiples of 2? Oop, you can't see that. I have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, right? It goes on and on and on. There's multiples are many. How about for 10? I have 10, 20, 30, right? But, oh, wait a second. Look, 10 is on both of those lists. So I'm going to use 10 as my common denominator. Hopefully, when I showed you this problem, you kind of saw that. Hopefully, we're getting to that point in the quarter where you're starting to see what the common denominator is without having to list out all of the multiples. So this one up here, it was 2 times something gives me 10. It was 5. So I multiply the top number by 5, which 5 times 1 is 5. And down here, 10 times something gives me 10. Well, it's just 1, right? So that means that this bottom guy, he doesn't really change. He just sort of moves over again, right? 3/10, 3/10. And now I can subtract. So what is 5/10 minus 3/10? 5 minus 3 is 2. And my bottom number stays the same. Now then, I have to ask myself the two questions, right? Is this a proper fraction? My answer is yes, it is, because that 2 on top is smaller. Is it reduced down as far as it can go? And so there, my answer is no. These are both even numbers, right? So I know automatically I can divide a 2 out of both of them. 2 divided by 2 is 1. 10 divided by 2 is 5. Okay, so this one I have a 1 on top. I know that I'm reduced down as far as I can go because there's a 1 right there. And so then I could say 1/2 minus 3/10 equals 1/5. There's my answer. Let's look at an example where we have unlike denominators and mixed numbers, because it's going to get crazy now, right? Because now we just have so much going on. But again, we're going to deal with these like they're in two columns, okay? A whole number column and a fraction column. And we're going to start with dealing with the fractions. So I have 8 on the bottom and I have 9 on the bottom. And I got to find my common denominator. Well, let's look at this. Let me scoot this up so we can look at, we have some space here. So I need to find 8 and 9. I'm going to find that I have to list them out for kind of a ways. I'm going to scoot this over. Sorry for that. 8 times 1 is 8. 8 times 2 is 16. Times 3 is 24. Times 4 is 32. Next multiple is 40. 48. 56. 8 times 8 is 64. 8 times 9 is 72. 8 times 10 is 80. I hope that's far enough out. How about for 9? I have 9. I have 18. 9 times 3 is 27. 9 times 4 is 36. 45, 54, 63. So, 72. There it is right there. Right? 72 is the least common multiple on both of these lists. That is so crazy. 72 is not a very small number, right? But it's the smallest that's on both lists. So 72 is going to be my common denominator. Okay, it was 8 times what got me to 72? It was 8 times 9, right? So now I multiply the top number by 9. 9 times 7 is 63. On the second fraction here, 9 times something gives me 72. Well, it's like the reverse of that guy, right? 9 times 8. So I'm going to multiply that 5 by 8 and get 40. And so here we have some bigger numbers. But luckily, with that common denominator, it's just a matter of subtracting the top numbers. 3 minus 0 is 3. 6 minus 4 is 2. And then I come over here and I subtract my whole numbers. 5 minus 4 is 1. Okay, so now I have to ask myself my two questions. Number one, is it a proper fraction? The answer is yes. Question number two, is it reduced down as far as it can go? And this is one sort of a tricky one because it feels like it should reduce down, right? 23 over 72, that's kind of a big fraction. Kind of a big fraction. But what do you notice about 23? It's prime. The only factors of 23 are 1 in itself. So unless 23 can divide evenly into 72, that's the only way that I could reduce this down. And it doesn't do that. 23 is not a factor of 72. So I know that my answer is reduced down as far as it can go.